हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ अ मैथ्स वर्कशीट 63, चैप्टर नंबर 11, मेजरमेंट। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वर्कशीट विल नॉट बी सबमिटेड ऑन द अर्थ सर। नाउ चैप्टर नंबर 11, मेजरमेंट, एस्टिमेशन इन मेजर्स। इन अवर डे टू डे लाइफ वी एस्टिमेट द मेजर्स। टू बी एबल To estimate measures correctly, you should have a fair idea of how to relate commonplace things with the commonly used units of measures. Students, can you estimate the length of this marker? The estimation measures of this marker in length is centimeter. So here, for short lengths, we use centimeters. And if we talk about for long lengths or distances, like example, what is the distance your house to Dehradun? The estimation is approx kilometer. And for medium lengths, like what is the length of your study table or this whiteboard? So we use meters for medium lengths, and for very short lengths we use millimeters. Example, like what is the length of this dash? The estimation measure of this dash is millimeter. So for long lengths, we use kilometer. For medium lengths, we use meter. For short lengths, we use centimeter. And for very short lengths, we use millimeter. Students, you measure the estimated length of your dining table. Which is best estimated length and best estimated units for your dining table? Next is mass. If we measure some weight of any object, so it's estimated by their mass. Like for very large masses, we use tons and quintal. Like if someone asks to you what is the estimated unit of weight of huge stone or huge rock, so it's approximately tons or quintal. Now here we solve some examples related to estimation in measures. Write the correct unit commonly used to measure the following things from the given box. So here these are some units which we use commonly to measure different things. Example number A, mass of a mango. So which is the estimated unit for mass of a mango? So the estimated unit for mass of a mango is gram. Next, example number B, capacity of a teacup. And this is also a small capacity, so we use milliliters. Now, example number C, capacity of a water tank for your home. So, the estimated unit for capacity of a water tank is liter. Example number D, mass of your school bag. So the estimated unit for mass of a school bag is kilogram. Now, finding fractions of quantities. So using this reference chart, we find fractions of quantities. Now, here we will solve some questions related to fractions of quantities. So the first example, 1 upon 10 gram in milligram. Here we change 1 upon 10 gram into milligram. So first we write and find how many milligram in 1 gram. So 1 gram equal to, so gram is here in the middle of this table, and we move to lower units because milligram is here, gram, decigram, centigram and milligram. So it moved 3 places to right hand side. So we say that 1 gram equal to 1000 milligram. So we multiply 1 upon 10 gram by 1000 milligram. So here 0 cancel out by 0 and 100 ones are 100. So we say that 1 upon 10 gram equal to 100 milligram. Now example number B, 3 upon 4 liter in centiliter. So here first we check how many centiliter in 1 liter. So 1 liter equal to, so liter is here in the middle of this table, and we move 2 places to the right hand side, 1, 2. So we say that 1 liter equal to 100 centiliter. After that we multiply 3 upon 4 liter by 100 centiliter. So when we divide 100 by 4, so we get 4 ones are 4. Now 4 twos are 8 and 4 fives are 20. And when you multiply 25 by 3, we get 75. So we write 75 centiliter. So 3 upon 4 liter in centiliter equal to 75 centiliters. Now example number C, 1 upon 5 kiloliter in hectoliter. So how many hectoliter in 1 kiloliter? So 1 kiloliter equal to, kiloliter is here, and we move one place to the right hand side. So we say that 1 kiloliter equal to 10 hectoliter. Now we multiply 1 upon 5 kiloliter by 10 hectoliter, and 10 divided by 5, 5 ones are 5 and 5 twos are 10, 2 times. So we write 2 ones are 2, 2 hectoliter. So 1 upon 5 kiloliter in hectoliter is equal to 2 hectoliter. Now next example, example number D, 4 upon 5 kilogram in gram. So 1 kilogram equal to, kilogram is here and it's moved 3 place to the right hand side. So we say that 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. Now we multiply 4 upon 5 by 1000 gram, and 1000 divided by 5, 5 is a 5, 5 to the 10, and 4 multiply by 200. So we use short method here. Now first we multiply these both number 4 and 2, and after that we put these two zeros, 4 to the 8, and now we put two zeros gram. 4 upon 5 kilogram in gram equal to 800 gram. Now example number E, 3 upon 2 hectometer in decameter. So how many decameter in 1 hectometer? So 1 hectometer equal to, hectometer is here and it's moved once place to the right hand side, so we write 10 decameter. 1 hectometer equal to 10 decameter. After that you multiply 3 upon 2 by 10 decameter. So 10 divided by 2, 2 ones are 2, 2 fives are 10, and 3 multiply by 5, 3 fives are 15, and write this unit as it is here, decameter. So 3 upon 2 hectometer in decameter equal to 15 decameter. Now example number F, 4 upon 25 meter in centimeter. So here first we check how many centimeters in 1 meter. So 1 meter equal to, meter is here in the middle of this table and it's moved 2 place to the right hand side. So we write 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. After that we multiply 4 upon 25 by 100 centimeter, and 25 divide 100 4 times, and when you multiply 4 by 4 we get 4 4s are 16 centimeter. So 4 upon 25 meter in centimeter equal to 16 centimeter. Dear students, in this exercise I give some questions related to above discussion, so you will do all these questions in your homework. Thank you, students.